Hello everyone, it's Ariel. In today's video, I thought I would do or start doing a Bob Ross style of videos to relax you. So, in my own kind of style, but this was inspired after my Q&A series of questions, which I've yet to upload. There's a lot of questions, and it's going to be quite a long video, so that's yet to be uploaded. So this is going to be in watercolours. Now before I begin, I haven't stretched this paper, so initially what I'd do is I'd use gum tape and make sure this paper was like saturated, stretch this, wait for the paper to dry and then begin the painting. So the whole aim of that is to prevent this paper from buckling as the paper gets saturated with the colour from the watercolours which I'm going to be using today. Now, I'm not particularly that amazing at painting. You can make mistakes and erase them by using water, so I'm much more skilled at drawing because I can get the precision with that, and I can't get that in painting, but I do like to do painting. So let's get started. So we have the water. We have the palette. I've had this since I was 16. And it's still going strong. So this is removable and it's decided it wants to not stay still. So these love putting water, but, and for mixing, and they're quite messy, but don't be alarmed. This is part and parcel of being an artist. It's like an organised chaos of mess. You've seen my carpet, it's covered in paint and makeup. I call it creativity. Most people would call it just mess. Okay, so I'm going to yellow colour here. So I've got quite a bit of this yellow colour. Unfortunately, I don't have the name of the colours. I don't have the name of the colours. This palette is quite ancient. I'm just gonna sweep across there. This is a makeup brush that I'm using. I'm just gonna do some gradients. This isn't the best paper to use, seeing as this is an experimental video. I thought I would see if this was going to be worth making some more of before I sort of delve into buying any materials, because art paper I think is so overpriced. So this is like a normal kind of paper, like a thin card. Normally you stretch paper. So we just paint with the yellow colour. And it doesn't matter if it's not even. And what we don't want is pencil lines or outlines. We want to be able to use just brush strokes, so it looks nice and clean without looking messy and distracting. So I'm going to use this. Is it yellow ochre. I'm not too sure, I need to find out. But I don't know. It's going across, like a mustard colour. It's going across. Just bring it down into the yellow. Water just on the top there and across back that way and across. So just rinse the brush with the water and we're going to go for some of this dark brown colour. So we're going to load the brush up with as much paint. Just going to flick, just flicking the barrel of the brush with index finger and the bird finger. The white. Do the same. Get rid of the excess water because you don't want to do this flicking motion and then a whole like load of water and paint end up on the actual paper. So just flick. Enough. Good. So we're going to get a darker colour now. Just get rid of the excess. We're going to go for what colour should we go for? Maybe some of the black. So just a little bit, but we want to dilute it, so you just dip it in here. Get rid of the excess, and I like to just squeeze the water up the end of the brush into the water receptacle. Just do a little flick. There we go. So get rid of that colour. Just squeeze that. No water. The thing we're going to do is we're going to get some of this aquamarine colour. Just brush, 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 brush. We want to kind of have the brush so that it's thin or more or less, so you can shape it with your fingers like that. I'm just going to gently stipple along the edge. Sporadically stipple. Now, cross contamination is something I'm terrible for doing, so I've gone straight into the darker blue there without rinsing the brush. Don't be alarmed, you can do that with, I do that with all my mediums. I know it's really bad. Just going across there. Going to just squeeze that excess water. We're just going to brush this upwards. So I'm using the water from the brush to dilute where that blue was, or is, and it's smudging it upwards. So it's like I'm creating like a blur. I'm kind of blurring it a little bit. And a bit of depth of field to it, kind of. So let's create something in the background. So this is the white colour, and I'm going to cross contaminate with the black colour just a little bit, and I'm just going to like that and that and clean. Just going to get rid of the excess. I'm going to just blend in. Blend by pushing. What's happening here is the paper is disintegrating into the ink, the paint. Didn't expect that, but it's kind of creating like a texture, which is working straight away. Kind of working a little bit. So get a bit more. It's quite intense. So get some white. I'm going to get a little bit of this plate, put some water, we're going to mix in here, so it's quite watered down, and we're just going to swirl around. Now, on proper canvas paper, this wouldn't happen. So, we should see things like this. I can get your name. Better props. This is an experiment. It's a lot more difficult to remove the colour on this paper, which is interesting, I've noticed. And I think I can scrape away that, yeah. Like push the colour. Okay. So there's some kind of like dark cloud or thunderstorm thing going on over there. Some little dots here. and swirl. Relax the brush. Mix some yellow. Mix some more yellow. Just do some little portions there like that. Mix some of the white in there. I'm going to go in with blue. There's enough blue for there, I think. I'm going to just go in there like that. Go in there like that. Go in there like that. So I haven't got the foggiest one I've painted. I just wondered if you found this relaxing, whether you'd like me to do any more of this, because I'd then consider getting gum strip and the paper, but and then I could paint something a bit more interesting than this rubbish. I hope you enjoyed this. Please do let me know, and I hope to see you in my next video. So don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you soon.